Malacanang says it has no details yet as to when the government's interagency COVID task force will meet to discuss new alert level classifications. The alert level status in areas across the country is set to expire on July 15th, Friday. But the palace says the task force will still continue to perform its functions under the new administration.
Hindi po namin masasabi yung kung kailan sila mag-meet. Ang masasabi lang po natin ay tuloy-tuloy naman po ang trabaho ng IATF. Hindi naman po sila naantala kahit po nagkabago ng administrasyon. So itinutuloy pa rin po ang IATF.
One of the country's largest hospitals, the Southern Philippines Medical Center, has announced it will only accommodate severe and critical cases for now. ABS-CBN correspondent Ernel Tocmo joins us on the line to tell us why. Ernel?
Good afternoon, Denise. We have just spoken to the chief of the Southern Philippines Medical Center here in Davao City regarding the influx of patients that their emergency department has been experiencing. Dr. Ricardo Audan said it is not due to COVID-19 cases. They observed increasing number of emergency admissions of patients diagnosed with pneumonia, stroke, renal problems, heart attack, and trauma cases. He said they do not know why there is an unusual number of emergency admissions. Currently, their original emergency room is being renovated, but it is transferred temporarily to a ward converted into an emergency room. Audan said that it has 115-bed capacity, but in the past days, they averaged to 160 emergency admissions, and there was a day that it reached to 200. On Wednesday, the SPMC announced on their social media account regarding the surge of patients in the ER, thus they will only be able to accept severe and critical cases of illnesses as of this time. The SPMC advised its healthcare partners or hospitals to adhere to coordinated transfers by getting in touch with the National Patient Navigation and Referral Center. SPMC, being the largest hospital in Mindanao with over 1,000 beds, is accepting not just patients from the Davao region, but from other parts of Mindanao as well. Dr. Audan advised those who have non-urgent conditions to access or coordinate with the hospital's teleconsultation or telemedicine that remains open from Mondays to Fridays at 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. However, the newly renovated emergency room is set to open on July 20, though it has less than 100-bed capacity, but their existing temporary ER will still remain. As of the latest statistics from SPMC, they logged 91 active cases of COVID-19 as of July 12, although this is higher compared to the active cases last July 1, which is 59. The ICU bed utilization rate is at 37.29%, while the ward bed utilization rate is at 51.74% as of July 12. Reporting from Davao City, Ernel Tocmo, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks, Ernel.
A former Philippine health secretary backs making the wearing of face masks optional if 70% of the population has received a COVID booster shot. For now, Janet Garin stresses the need to wear face masks due to COVID variants.
Apat ang core functions ng bakuna. Yung third function, which is to reduce transmission, has been compromised by the Delta and the Omicron variant. So kung ako ang tatanungin nyo, we can go into an optional mask policy if we reach 70% boosted population.
According to Garin, other core functions of a vaccine are to prevent deaths and to reduce hospitalizations and mutations. Garin, who is also Iloilo's first district representative, calls for redefining the term fully immunized to include the booster dose.
Alam naman natin, nagbago ang siyensya, nagbago at lumakas yung virus. The booster dose will mean continuous protection for you, your family, and your co-workers, and would maintain your wall of immunity.
An infectious disease, as expert believes, the worst of the COVID pandemic is over because of the vaccines. But Dr. Edsel Salvania reminds the public to remain cautious, saying COVID transmissions are ongoing. He says mutations will continue to take place as many have yet to receive a COVID booster shot.
if you count the number of deaths. Even though almost triple yung cases na nakita natin sa Omicron nung January, yung number of deaths was nowhere near that of yung nakita natin sa Delta. So dun pa lang, masasabi na natin na because of vaccines, the worst is really over for the pandemic. Pero of course, there's nothing that will stop the virus from continuing to mutate.